Good morning, second graders. Welcome to the last week of school. Today for Bible, we are looking at a hero of the faith. And his name is Abraham Kuyper, I believe is how you pronounce it. I could be wrong. It's K-U-Y-P-E-R. I think it's pronounced Kuyper. But before we start on the story, the Bible verse for this week is Psalms 103, verse 12. Again, that's Psalms chapter 103, verse 12. And it says, "He has removed our sins as far from us as the east is from the west," which means he's taken our sins far, far away. And because of that, it was because of Jesus' death on the cross that we are forgiven. All right, so Abraham. Oh, you know what? I just found out how it's pronounced Kuyper. His name is pronounced Abraham Kuyper. All right, so let's see what he did. And the page on in your Bible books is 242. So it's going to be towards the back of your Bible book. It's going to have kind of a green border at the top of it. Abraham Kuyper was born into the home of a pastor in the Netherlands in 1837. Bram, as his family called him, loved the sea. He often played near the canals or walked down to the harbor to watch the ships sailing away. He dreamed one day of attending the maritime school to study navigation. Abraham also loved to read the newspaper. As he grew older, his dream of being a sea captain changed. He began to pay close attention to news reports. He loved to read and hear about politics. He decided to study at the Leiden University. He was a very good student. He earned money by tutoring other students. One day, he used the money he had saved to buy a picture. The large painting of Christ on the cross was called Christ Crucified. Looking at the picture made Abraham feel guilty and sad, but he was not sure why. He began to study to be a preacher. The university didn't teach the same things that the Bible teaches. Abraham trusted what his teacher said instead of what he had learned as a child. One teacher told his class that he didn't believe Jesus rose from the dead. Abraham and the other students applauded. Abraham graduated and married a lady named Joanna when he was 25 years old. He was asked to be the minister of a small village church at about the same time. Abraham had many questions in his mind about God. He didn't agree with all of the Bible teachings about salvation and Jesus Christ, but he still felt that he wanted to preach more than what He still felt that he needed to preach more than he wanted to do anything else. A few people in his church weren't happy with his doctrine. As he visited with various families, he began to see that they all believed in the Bible. They believed that Jesus Christ is God's son and that salvation from sin was through him alone, not through any human effort. Abraham found himself listening to these people instead of trying to argue with them. These people know what they believe, he thought. They are not ashamed to tell others about their beliefs, and I admire that. One lady refused to attend church because God's word was not being taught there. She read her Bible and studied other books at home. Whenever Abraham went to visit her, she pleaded with him to forget the false teachings and believe what the Bible says. God worked in Abraham's heart, and he soon trusted Jesus Christ as his Savior. Abraham's habit of reading the newspaper as a boy helped him become a good writer of news articles. When he wasn't preaching, he wrote newspaper articles and pamphlets to show that the Bible is true. He also wrote about his ideas for making the Netherlands a better country. Soon, he became the editor of a newspaper he was writing for. Abraham found other ways to speak the truth. He served as a member of parliament for 3 years and later as prime minister of the Netherlands. He wrote books and founded a university that taught students the truth about God's word. When he was an old man, he sometimes looked up to the wall above his bed. There hung a picture, Christ crucified, to remind Abraham of the one he loved and had lived for, the Savior he would soon see face to face. All right, again, that was Abraham Kuyper. Again, you'll find that on page 242 in your Bible Truths books towards the back. It's going to have like a green border on the top of it, and you can see his picture right there. What you need to do for Bible today is there's a little area that you need to read, so it's like two paragraphs, and then you need to put the events in order, labeling them 1 to 5. It says write a number besides each sentence to show the order in which the events happened. All right, so that was about Abraham Kuyper. Real quickly, our Bible verse again for this week is Psalms chapter 103, verse 12. He has removed our sins as far from us as the east is from the west. All right. I hope you have a great day, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.